What's up, gamers? Avatar 2 was finally landed 13 years after the first. I went from this to this, and Big Jim here went from this to this. And I have to be upfront here, I've never seen the original, like, ever. I've tried watching it a few years ago. I was getting ready to go to
Pandora, the world of Avatar,
in Disney World, and my family thought, hey, maybe we can get caught up to date on the lore or whatever. I fell asleep in the first 15 minutes. I have absolutely no attachment to this franchise, no investment in any of the lore, and no interest. But over the past few months, through podcasts and videos and theme park rides, I became pretty locked into the world of Avatar, and a tiny little itty-bitty microscopic part of me was actually kind of interested in Avatar 2, at least to see what the big kind of technical achievements Big Jim was talking up. I mean, for God's sakes, 13 years? I went to go see this movie with my brother very last minute. I was off 4 hours of sleep, very sick, might have taken an edible, and right center of a 3D viewing. The whole time I was fighting, throwing up, extremely dizzy, and disoriented by the 3D. It was like pouring boiling water on my poor little brain. If that wasn't the intended way of viewing this movie, then I don't know what is. Well, what did I think of Avatar: The Way of Water? I liked it. I quite liked it a lot, actually. I think there's some really strong pieces in this Jenga tower that stay pretty stable throughout the 3-hour runtime. Those 3 hours can be a lot, though, and I think there's so much here that could have been condensed or even cut out, because wow, this movie is a lot of movie. Let me get it out of the way first. This movie is gorgeous. This really is some of the best CGI to ever come from any studio. The environments are intricately detailed and insanely beautiful. The plants and creatures all have such eye-catching designs. The colors are all vibrant, and the water is just insane. For the amount of time spent in the water, the studio really knew to make sure the water looked appealing and inviting and beautiful. The animation in the Na'vi is so well done, and I think because they limit the amount of interactivity they have with the humans in this movie, it really allows your brain to be more immersed in the animation and process like you would live action. There genuinely were some points in the movie where I forgot I was watching CGI blue people. It felt so real, it was incredible. I love the differences between the two Na'vi tribes too, the physical design differences, the little cultural differences. Is it weird that a white man with dreads is suddenly the savior of not just an African-inspired tribe, but also a Polynesian-inspired tribe? A white military man? But hey, that's what the movie's about anyway! And I do think there's a pretty strong story here too. I love what the movie does with
Jake Sully!
And I think the new characters are all fun and add to his character motivation. Except Spider, man, I fucking hate Spider. There were multiple times during the screening I turned to my brother and said, man, I hope Spider dies. I hate his stupid hair, I hate his vocabulary, I hate his dumb dual allegiance thing. I hate this little brat so much. I do think most of the cast give solid performances, especially Stephen Lang. Man, this guy is just relishing being the bad guy. He's having a blast in this role. Side note, his stupid army cronies with their Avatar tattoos and Oakley sunglasses are the ugliest designs ever. And that's why they're so funny and so easy to hate. These guys fucking suck. They're perfect villains. I think the movie does a good job starting off the story, recapping the 13 years between movies, while making the exposition at least visually interesting. I think it is a lot to take in, and I think the movie is full of expo dumps like this, which could turn a lot of people off. I think the dynamics the story sets up, especially the family dynamic and their different relationships to each other, and how that evolves over the film is really well done. The story is just great in this thing. There's lots of little moments of setup and payoff, and it's a really successful three-act structure. But in that, there's way too many scenes of just taking in different pieces of nature that go on for way too long. Some plot points, like the rivalry between the two groups of kids and Jemaine Clement's dumb moral strugglings or whatever, just aren't brought up again once they've served their narrative purpose. Some scenes go on for way too long, like the attack on the sea animals, or the swimming montages, or the entire last bit of narration. The entire middle hour drags on and brings the pacing to a near halt. Some of the scenes can be a little visually overstimulating and bleed into your brain. The weird Australian bad guy just comes out of nowhere and does nothing for the story. Why is he in this? The 3-hour runtime doesn't help your brain retain any of that information. But thrown into this movie are some incredibly exciting action sequences. The set pieces in this movie are all big and bombastic and beautiful, from huge explosive scenes like the ocean attack or the escape from the big fish, or moments of levity like swim with big whale. There's some really memorable pieces of filmmaking that show off the best of what James Cameron has to offer. You have the slow-build romance and the water disaster a la Titanic, tense industrial action and brutal combat like Terminator, scenes of disaster ripped right out of T2 or Aliens. There's some really incredible stuff here, and even if it's just sandwiched between some unnecessary parts, it really makes this movie a spectacle. Scenes that bring back that sense of grandiosity and wonder to average cinema and shows off the limits of what the technology can do. Avatar: The Way of Water is really worth it. If you can see it on the biggest screen possible with the nicest projector they have, do it. It's worth it. It really is something to be seen. And hey, that's Avatar 2. What did you think? Let me know in the comments below. Like, share, subscribe, and remember,
swim with big whale.